स्वेच्छाकेसरिणः स्वच्छस्वच्छाय आयासित इन्दवः त्रायन्तां वो मधुरिपोः प्रपन्नार्तिच्छिदो नखाः. वि लुक्ड् एट् द डेफिनेशन् आफ् रसवदलङ्कार. प्रधाने अन्यत्र वाक्यार्थे यत्राङ्गं तु रसादयः काव्ये तस्मिन् अलङ्कारो रसादिरिति मे मतिः. एस् एन् एक्स्प्लेनेशन् फार् दिस् कारिका he is giving five examples. First he gives two examples dividing the rasavadalankara into shuddha and sankara, and then he deals with a small topic called chetana chetana vishaye rasavadalankarasya astitvam, and then he moves on to guna and alankara. So yadyapi rasavadalankarasya annehi darshitah vishayah, तथापि यस्मिन् काव्ये प्रधानतया अन्यो अर्थः वाक्यार्थीभूतः तस्य च अङ्गभूता ये रसादयः ते रसादेः अलङ्कारस्य विषयाः इति मामकीनः पक्षः इति मे मतिः. द स्पेसिफिक् स्ट्रेस् फार् मामकीनः पक्षः वेर् हि सेस् दिस् इस् मै अण्डर्स्टाण्डिङ्ग् और् दिस् इस् मै स्टान्स् as far as rasavadalankara goes, that is being dealt with the chetana chetana vishayam. We will look at it again later. So tadyata chatushu preyo alankarasya vakyarthatve api rasadayah angabhutah drishyante. Chatu is a prashamsa param priya vakyam. In Bhamaha's alankara shastra, where he has defined a lot of alankaras, he says that preyo alankara is chatu. Anything that has a chatu ukti is called a preyo alankaram. Alankaras have been defined and redefined over centuries, decades. So here, what Bhamaha started with is not what is followed by Apaya Dikshita in the 15th century. So there is a huge gap between how people have defined that. So the in as far as preyo alankara goes, in Bhamaha's tradition, it is Chatu Ukti, and Arandavardhana follows that and says, Tad yatha Chatushu Preyo Alankarasya Vakyarthatve Api. And in Chatu, it is Preyo Alankara. Preyas is Priyan Alankaraha, Priyataraha Alankaraha, whatever is the very dear to us, which is very nice to see, that alankaram is preyo alankaram. So it's a very vague concept that he takes up. But the preyo alankaram that we know about after Rape Dikshitar and Sahitya Darpana, Kavya Prakasha, etc., the preyo alankaraha is when one bhavam or rasam becomes an anga to another bhava or rasa. That is called preyo alankaraha. Urjasvi is where rasa bhasa and bhava bhasa have become an angam for another. And Bhava Shanti has become an another angam, has become an anga to another thing, is Samahita Alankara. It can either be an anga for a vastu or another bhava or rasa. When Bhava Shabalata, Bhava Odayaha, and Bhava Sandhi, these are all called by their own names as Bhava Sandhi Alankaraha, Bhava Shabalata Alankaraha, and Bhava Odaya Alankara. Next, he divides Rasavadalankara into two. स च रसादिः अलङ्कारः शुद्धः सङ्कीर्णः वा. सो इट् इस् ऐदर् अ शुद्ध वेर् देर् इस् ओन्ली वन् रसम् आर् सङ्कीर्ण वेर् देर् आर् टु रसस्. एण्ड् किं द फस्ट् श्लोकं दट् हि गिव्स् दि एक्साम्पल् फार् शुद्ध रसवदलङ्कार इस् तत्र आद्यः यथा किं हास्येन न मे प्रयास्यसि पुनः प्राप्तश्चिराद्दर्शनं केयं निष्करुण प्रवासरुचिता केनासि दूरीकृतः स्वप्रान्तेष्विति ते वदन् प्रियतमव्यासक्तकण्ठग्रहः बुद्ध्वा रोदिति रिक्तबाहुवलयस्तारं रिपुस्त्री जनः. कविः अत्र नृपं प्रशंसते. दिस् इस् अ कवि हू इस् प्रेसिङ्ग् द किङ्ग्. And he's actually talking of the how the enemy wives are dreaming about their beloved, dreaming about the king's enemies. So the enemy's wives are dreaming about their husbands, and they wake up crying because they, in their dreams, they are talking to them and they're embracing them, and suddenly they wake up and find that their arms are empty. There is nobody in their bahu valayam. Rikta bahu valayaha taram roditi. So they immediately cry very loudly. Kim hasyena? Hasyena kim? Why are you laughing? Na kimapi, there is no prayojanam. Chirate me darshanam praptaha. So after a long time, they have been separated from their beloved. The beloved is dead here. So they are, so after a long time, these ladies are seeing them in their dreams. So, and they're seeing the smiling face of their beloveds, and they're saying, Hasyena kim? Why are you laughing now? Why are you, why do you laugh at me? Chirat me darshanam praptaha punaha na prayasyasi. So you're laughing with something in your mind. That means you're going to vanish away immediately, and that's why you're giving me a smile. So chirat darshanam praptaha. After a long time, I'm seeing you in my dreams. Punaha na prayasyasi. Don't go again. Dainyam atra. Now, it is a Karuna rasam, which is the angam here. So it's a description of Karuna rasam here. So why are you laughing? Don't laugh at me like this. Chirat ne darshanam praptaha. I'm seeing you after a long time. Punaha na prayasyasi. You cannot go away again. Away from my sight. Hey Nishkaruna, you're so cruel. Tava iyam pravasa ruchita ka keyam Nishkaruna pravasa ruchita. Why do you always want to stay away from me? Pravasam is dura desha gamanam. So you always want to stay elsewhere. What is this ruchita? What is this ruchihi that you have to stay away from me? Ka iyam ruchita. Kenasi duri krataha. When did I ever, you know, send you away? Kena duri krataha asi. Duri krataha means who has sent you away. One is, on what mission have you gone away? Or kena duri krataha asi. Kena aparadhena duri krataha. See, what is that mistake that you did that you have been banished for so long? Swapranteshu iti te priyatama vyasakta kantagraha. They are thinking and they're clinging to their husband's necks. You know, they're embracing them. Iti vadan swapranteshu, at the end of the swapnam, what happens is priya. Priyatama vyasakta kantagraha ripustri janaha buddhva. In their swapnam, they are embracing their husbands and they are saying, don't go. Why do you always want to go away? Who sent you away? What is the mistake that you did? Why are you laughing? I'm seeing you after a long time. Don't go away. So iti swapnanteshu evam rupam swapna evam vidaha swapnaha. So the dream was in such a manner. Iti vadan, and they are just blabbering something when they wake up. You know, sometimes during dreams you can. So priyatama vyasanka kantagraha stripustri janaha. The ladies of that, those enemies, your enemies, they are embracing their beloved buddhva. They wake up from this dream, and then rikta bahu valayaha. They look at the empty circle of arms. Taram roditi. And they cry. So, there are two meanings for this rikta bahu valayaha. Rikta bahu, bahu valayam means the circle of arms. That is, they are embracing them and they see that there is nobody there to embrace. So that is rikta, shunyam. Or bahu valayam is they are not wearing any bangles. When your husband is no more, they don't wear bangles, and that is the tradition. So rikta bahu valayam drishtva taram roditi ripustri janaha. Here the main purport of this verse is the vastudhvani, which is the greatness of the prowess of the king. Nripati prabhavaha eva atra alankarya vastu, that is your main. But the rasam, see, rasadvani is the atma. When the rasa becomes an alankaraha for the alankarya vastu, so the alankaryam is the rajnyaha prabhavaha. Nripati prabhavaha atra. that which has to be decorated. What is being used here to decorate that is Karuna. So that Karuna Rasam, where you have the Alambana Vibhava, is the Ripustri Janaha. Uddipanam is the Swapna Darshanam. Shoka Sthayi Bhavam is the Shoka is the Sthayi Bhavam, and because of the, you know, Taram Roditi and Rikta Bahu Valayaha, Chirat Darshanam, these are all the words that give us both Anubhava and the Vibhichari Bhava. So the Kantagraha is the Anubhava, Vibhichari Bhava is the Dainyam, Chirat Swapna Darshanam, all of these are Vibhichari Bhava. And then Ashru, Ashrupataha, you have all Sattvika Bhava, Vyavichari Bhava, Anubhava, and Buddhipanam, Alambaram, both are there. Everything. So because of this, the Shoka Sthayi Bhava becomes a Karuna Rasam, but that Karuna Rasam is expressed where the main reason for saying the shloka is to praise the king in front. So it is in praise of the king. So the Kavi wants to praise the king, right? So the purport of this is not the Karuna Rasam, but the prowess of the king. Okay? So this is only when one Rasam is there. In the next one, there are two Rasas which are mixed together. Okay? Is there a doubt, Rika?
The Tiye vandu Tavaragnyaha ka pogadha. Swapnesh Swapnan Teshu iti Te Vadan.
Oh, Adam Parapakali Ama. Yes. Te Ripu Stri Janaha.
Okay.
So Te Ripu Stri Tava Ripunam Striyaha. Anga Chetakam. Okay. So it is Ragnyaha. Next is Sankirnaha Rasadihi Angabhutaha Yata. Kshipto, I didn't read the Vritti in that. There is no Vritti. इत्यत्र करुणरसस्य शुद्धस्य अंगभावात् स्पष्टमेव रसवदलंकारत्वं एवं एवं विधे विषये रसांतराणां स्पष्टः एव अंगभावः इन द वृत्ति इन द अर्लियर वन सो इत्यत्र इन द श्लोक करुणरसस्य शुद्धस्य अंगभावात् करुणरस शुद्ध करुणरस ओनली करुणरस हैज बिकम एन अंगभावम हैज बिकम सब्सिडरी सबॉर्डिनेट टू द main idea, which is Ragnyaha Prabhavaha, Shauryam. So, evam, thus, evam vidhe vishaye, in such cases, evam vidhe vishaye, wherever there is an anya pradhanam, anyarthasya vakyarthi bhave, atava pradhana bhave, sati, tatra, rasantaranam api spashtaha eva angabhavaha. You can have Adbhuta Rasam, you can have Vayanaka Rasam, anything can be, any rasa can be used as a subordinate to a principal idea, which is like Deva Vishayaka Rati, Atava Raja Vishayaka Rati, anything. Sankirnaha Rasadihi Angabhutaha Yatha Kshipto Hastavalagnaha Prasabham Abhihataha Abhihato Pyadadano Amshukantam ग्रन्हन केशेश्वपास्तः चरण निपतितः नीक्षित संभ्रमेण आलिंगन्यो अवधूतः त्रिपुर युवतिभिः साश्रु नेत्रोत्पलाभिः कामीव आर्द्रापराधः स दहतु दुरितं शाम्भवो वः शराग्निः शाम्भवः शराग्निः सः वः दुरितं दहतु मेन सेंटेंस ऑफ द श्लोक सो शाम्भवः द शराग्निः शर अग्नि दि fire that comes from the arrow. This is Tripura Samhara. So when Shiva destroys the three cities, Tripura, he uses fire and burns the entire three cities. So Shambhavaha Sharagnihi, Shivasya Bana Agnihi, Vaha Yushmakam Bhaktanam Duritam Papam Dahatu. Let that fire which destroyed the Tripura destroy your papam also. So everything else is an adjective to that Sharagni. The first, where the rasa is mentioned is Kami Iva Ardra Aparadhaha Kami Iva. He is comparing the Sharagni, fire from the arrow, to a Kami, a beloved, who is Ardra Aparadhaha, who has just committed a mistake, fresh. This is recently committed a mistake, and he is trying to placate the lover. The rest is how that lover acts. So she, the moment, you know, kshiptaha, hasta avalagnaha, hasta avalagnaha, kshiptaha. So the moment, both will go for the fire and a kami. So let's just look at the kami first. Huh? So when he has committed a mistake, he will first catch hold of her hand. Hasta avalagnaha. He will hold on to her hand and say, you know, forgive me. So kshiptaha. So the moment when you are very angry and someone holds, catches your arm, you will immediately, you know, shake off that arm. Right? So kshiptaha. Kshiptaha means not thrown, but you just shake it off. You just, the தமிழ்ல உதறி தள்ளுறதுன்னு போகும் அதுதான் கஷிப்தகாங்கிறது கையை பிடிச்ச மாத்திரத்துல அப்படியே உதறி விடுவான் கோவத்துல ஸோ வென் யூ ஆர் ஆங்கிரி யூ இம்மிடியட்லி ஷேக் ஆஃப் யுவர் ஹேண்ட் அண்ட் லெட் கோ ஆஃப் இட் ரைட் ஸோ தட் இஸ் த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் நெக்ஸ்ட் இஸ் அம்சுகாந்தம் ஆததானா பிரசபம் அபிஹதா அபி அம்சுகாந்தம் ஆததானா ஸோ ஆஸ் யூ ஷேக் ஆஃப் த ஹேண்ட் ஆஃப் யுவர் லவர் இட் மே by because of the anger that you have in your yourself by chance it may be you know not violent but you may hit unknowingly so prasabam abhihataha here he says even prasabam abhihataha malavikagna mitram iravati takes the hip chain you know that udyana and she tries to hit agni mitra because he committed a mistake so they even hit it seems so when she tries to hit him prasabam abhihataha api even though he is hit or hurt really very much adadanaha amshukantam now he cannot catch her hand so he catches hold of the pallu that is the next thing that because when that pallu is near the hand no so the moment the hand is slipped and with that force the pallu is very thin and it shakes in the air so it's easier to catch that so he catches that amshukantam catches hold of her utariya vastram so adada amshukantam adadanaha prasabam abhihataha api adadanaha next is apastaha now she moves away and takes her pallu If you should imagine that scene, it's so beautifully described. So she takes out apastaha, he is tiraskritaha api kesheshu grinhan because she moves away and turns, he sees her keshapasham and takes hold of her veni. So kesheshu grinhan apastaha and she again tiraskritaha, then he falls down charana nipatitaha. He falls down at her feet. And then avadhutaha, he's tiraskritaha, charana nipatitaha, na ikshitaha sambramena. She's so agitated and she wants to move away from him that even though he falls at her feet, she doesn't look at him. Na ikshitaha. He was not noticed because of sambramena. Yaha sa ashru netrotpalabihi Tripura Yuvati Bihi Yaha Avadhutaha. Next is Avadhutaha. Now, this is just a Kami description. Avadhutaha means Tiraskritaha Saha Alingati. He sees the tears in her eyes, even though she Yadyapi Sa Tiraskaram Karoti Tathapi Tasyaha Manasi Dukham Vartate. So that is seen in her Ashru Netrotpala. So she's tearing up and he sees that and embraces her. Avadhutaha api alingan or alingan avadhutaha. When he embraces her, she does not look at him. Avadhutaha tiraskritaha. Kami eva ardraparadaha. Now how does all of this fit for the Agni? The moment, you know, you touch Agni, the moment you touch fire, you will immediately shake off your hand. So, hastavalagraha kshiptaha. Because of that hurried behavior, the fire can just catch your amshukam. So, this is a description of Tripura Yuvati Bihi, Yuvati. All the ladies who are there in that Tripura, the three cities. So, the fire which spreads First, they touch the fire, and then they are so shocked that they shatter, you know, they shake off, and when it is caught, and then it catches the hem of their dress. So Adadanaha, Amshukantam Adadanaha, when it comes and catches the cloth, what do? Immediately you just stamp it. So Prasavam Abhihataha. For Agni, everything you put it in front so that it's easier to do the Anvayam. So Hastavalagnaha Kshiptaha Agnihi. Kintu Saha Kshiptaha Hastavalagnaha. You have to try to do the Anvayam this way and that way for both the Kami and the Agni. Okay. So here, Amshukantam Adadanaha Agnihi Prasabham Abhihataha. The moment fire catches your sari, you will want to stamp it down. So Prasabham Abhihataha. Kesheshu Grindhanna Apastaha. Then it catches fire. Your hair catches fire. Imagine the whole city is burning. So people are also burning and, you know, it's there. They're crying there. So this is Karuna Rasam, this one. So Kami Iva Ardra Aparadaha is actually Irshya Vipralambha, where there is a Kopam. Kupita Naika Asti, and the Kami is trying to placate her. Santvanam Karoti. So there is an Irshya Vipralambham there. Here, it is when you are trying to describe the Tripura Yuvati, it is a Karuna Rasam. Kesheshu Grinhan Apastaha. The moment it catches, your hair catches fire, you try, it's seized, it is denied. So when the apastaha means you try to remove that fire, right? Kesheshu grindhan agnihi apastaha saha charana nipatitaha. When it comes and falls down on the feet, when the floors are all burning, you don't realize, you want to just get out, you want to escape. So sambramena na ikshitaha, where there is fire and where there is no fire, you don't even realize when you are trying to rush out of a building like that. So charana nipatitaha agnihi api sambramena, because of agitation, na ikshitaha, it was not seen. Avadutaha yaha Sashru netrotpalabihi tripura yuvativihi alingan avadutaha. It was scorned when it came and tried to, you know, embrace the ladies who were all with Ashru netram. Sashru Ashru netrotpalabihi tripura yuvativihi yatha yada saha alingyate tada agnihi avadhutaha tiraskritaha. Tadrishaha shambhavaha sharagnihi. That Agni was trying to destroy the entire city. And he is asking that Agni to destroy the papam in you. So here the main idea is Shiva. Vakyartham is the main purport, is the extraordinary power of Shiva. Just his, the fire that comes out of his arrow is capable of destroying the three cities. No? Tripura Samharam happened because Narayana became the banam for him, and he used that bana to destroy the three cities. Right? So it is the prowess of Shiva that is being described here. That is your Vakyartham or Pradhanam. The Rasam is actually Apradhanam, where it becomes an Alankara, it highlights that. And so it is called Rasavadalankaram. Here two rasas are employed. One is the Irsha Vipralambha and the other is the Karuna. So ityatra Tripura Ripu Prabhava Atishayasya. Tripura Ripu Tripurasya Ripuhu Shivaha. Shivasya Prabhava Atishayasya. Prabhava Atishaya, his extraordinary power. Shiva's extraordinary power, Parameshwara's extraordinary power is the Vakyarthatve. Vakyarthatve Pradhani Bhute. When it is the Pradhanam, Irshya Vipralambasya, Shlesha Sahitasya. Shlesham, along with Shlesha, Angabhavaha. He doesn't talk about Karuna Rasam. He just says, because it is Kamiva Ardra Paradaha, he just talks about Irshya Vipralambam. There was another Vyakhyanam where he said Karunam is also there. Karuna and Vipralamba both are there. Vipralambasya alankaratvam natu vakyarthata ataha hetu. Okay. There was some, I read one Vyakhyanam where he said that Karuna Rasa is also there.
இந்த தீதித்தில ஏதோ போட்டிருக்கார் அவர்.
இல்லையா? ஆமா.
யத்யபி கருணாக அபி இஹ அஸ்தி ஏவ ரசஹ ததாபி தஸ்ய விச்சித்தி விசேஷான் விசேஷ சத்திங் ஆதாயகத்வாதா அநாதாயகத்வாதா அங்காங்கத்வேன உபாதான வித்தியக்கே. ரெண்டாவது இதுல இருக்கு பேராகிராஃப்ல, எத்தனாவது பக்கம், 74வது.
அத்ரஹி சிவப்பிரபாவ அதிசய அங்கி பரேஷாம் தஸ்யைவ உபஸ்கரணாத் தஸ்ய ஈர்ஷா விப்ரலம்பஹ அங்கம் சச்ச ந சுத்தஹ கிந்து ஸ்லேஷாலங்கார பிரசாதிதஹ. சோ இட் இஸ் அலாங் வித் ஸ்லேஷாலங்கார. ஸ்லேஷஸ்து க்ஷிப்த இதி ஓகே. யத்யபி கருணஹ அபி இஹ அஸ்தி ஏவ ரஸஹ ததாபி தஸ்ய விச்சித்தி விசேஷ அநாதாயகத்வாத் அங்காங்கத்வேன அனுபாதானம் இத்யேகே. Even though Karuna Rasa is present here, Vichitti Vishesha, it is not providing a beauty. It's more the... okay. Karuna Rasam is not more Pradhanam, whereas the Shlesha and the... Even though there is Karuna Rasa, so we can take it as three levels. The first one is where Shiva Prabhava Atishayaha, that is your Vakyartham, that is the Pradhanam. He is using Irsha Vipralambam and Shlesha on a parallel level. The next level is Karuna, where all the women are catching fire. So the people are all getting destroyed. I don't know how to use it in English. So that Karuna Rasam is your, it is more subsidiary to all these things. It is more subordinate to all these things. So it is not as beautiful as the Irsha Vipralambam or the Shlesha that is there. So that is why he is not taking that as a sankirna here. He is only taking rasa as an alankara and slesha, the shabda alankara or artha slesha also here. So it is both of them are sankirna. They both go together to highlight Shiva's prabhava. So that is why here he doesn't use karuna rasam here. You know, there is no talk of dying, maranam, they're not there, and all that is not being highlighted here. The Karuna Rasam is not so pradhanam. Okay. Kshipto hastavalagnaha prasabha mahiyataha api adadano amshukantam grinhan kesheshvapastaha charana nipatitaha nekshita sambramena alinganyo avadhutaha tripura yuvatibihi sashru netpotpalabihi காமீவார்த்ராபராதஹ சதஹது துரிதம் சாம்போவஷராக்னிஹ. சோ இத்யத்ர த்ரிபுர ரிபு பிரபாவ அதிசயஸ்ய வாக்யார்த்தத்வே ஈர்ஷ்யா விப்ரலம்பஸ்ய ஸ்லேஷ சஹிதஸ்ய அங்கபாவஹ. சோ ஹியர் அங்கம் பிரதானம் இஸ் சிவஸ்ய அதிசயஹ, எக்ஸ்ட்ராடினரி பவர் ஆஃப் சிவா. நெக்ஸ்ட் இஸ் அங்கபூதாஹ ஈர்ஷ்யா விப்ரலம்பஹ ரஸஹ ததா ஸ்லேஷாலங்காரஹ ச. ஏவம் வித ஏவ ரசவதாதி அலங்காரஸ்ய நியாயஹ விஷயஹ ஏவம் விதஹ ஏவ ரசவத அலங்காரஸ்ய உதாரணம் பவிதும் சக்யதே. தட் இஸ் வேர் ரசஸ்ய அப்ரதானத்துவம் வித்யதே தத்ரைவ ரசவத அலங்காரஸ்ய விஷயஹ. அதயேவ ச ஈர்ஷ்யா விப்ரலம்ப கருணயோஹோ. ஓஹோ, ஐ டிட் ஓகே, I did not. Oh, it's there. Sorry. Irshya atayevacha irshya vipralamba karunayoho angatvena vyavasthanat samaveshaha na doshaha. See, irshya vipralamba and karuna, this may not be, that is why I got confused that Anandavardhana could have mentioned irshya vipralamba and karuna as sankaram. This is a virodhi rasam, right? Vipralambha means when there is only a separation and there is a hope of joining later. Karuna means there is no hope of joining at all, where one or the other person is dead, completely separated. So there is a karuna rasam. Karuna and vipralambha can never go together, whereas this is an example where both karuna and vipralambha can exist together. So, Atayeva, Irshya Vipralambha, Karunayoho, Angatvena, even though both of them are Anga, people interpret it in this different manner. One say that Anandavardhana wants to emphasize that there is both Irsha Vipralamba and Karuna in this shlokam. I feel there is Karunam, and it is only a very thin layer underlying everything. Right? So that is, you can't, it has not been highlighted with everything. Alambanam, Uddipanam, everything is not there. All the Alambanam, Uddipana is more for the Irsha Vipralamba than the Karunarasam here. So Angatvena Vyavasthanat Na Doshaha. We saw in Auchitya Vicharam where you can even have Shringara and Bibatsa together. Virodhirase api, the way it was put together was Shantarasam was Pradhanam, Angirasaha, and then he brought in Shringara, Bibatsa, Karuna, everything in one shlokam as an Anga. Virodhirasam can be, you can't have Virodhirasa as an Angi. You can't have two rasas as Angi there. And both cannot be Virodham. State of position. So, Angatvena Vyavasthanat Na Doshaha. There is no Samaveshaha Na Doshaha. There is no fault here in this. Even though Irsha Vipralamba and Karunarasam are there. Okay.
இந்த ஸ்லோகம் ரொம்ப அழகா இருக்கு எனக்கு. அந்த ஈஷா விபிரலம் ரொம்ப ரொம்ப அழகா இருக்கு. பட் ஆனா எனக்கு அது வந்து எப்படி எக்ஸாக்ட்லி திஸ் சம்புவோட பிரபாவ அதிசயத்தை அலங்காரம் பண்றதுன்னு புரியல. அங்கமா இருக்குன்னா அது எப்படி இப்ப முன் ஸ்லோகத்துல புரிஞ்சுது எப்படி அந்த கருணரசம் வந்து ராஜாவோட பிரபாவத்தை சொல்றது. அது ஈஸியா புரிஞ்சுடுத்த ஒரு மாதிரி. அவ அழறா அவள் அழ வைக்கிற அளவுக்கு இவன் வந்து இவ்வளோ
பண்ணிருக்கான்னா வந்து So the prowess, fire is such thing, is such that, you know, kaila pattudina, you can just shake it off. Kaila tunila irundhudina, you can just stamp it away and do it. But the power of Shiva's Agni, Sharagni, is such that they couldn't do anything. It ultimately, it just aalingannu. It just enveloped them in flames. They couldn't extinguish it in whatever manner. It was everywhere. அதுதானே. பரமேஸ்வரனுடைய பிரபாவம்னா எப்பவுமே அது இருந்துட்டு இருக்கு. அந்த ஷராக்னி இஸ் ஆல்வேஸ் பிரசன்ட், எவர் பிரசன்ட், அண்ட் இட் கேன் இட் ஹாஸ் த கேபபிலிட்டி ஆஃப் ரிமூவிங் த பாபம்.
ஈர்ஷியா விபரலம்பத்துல அந்த காமி எவ்வளவு வந்து திருப்பி திருப்பி ரிலன்ட்லெஸ்ஸா வந்துட்டு இருப்பானோ அது மாதிரி இதுவும் ஓகே. அந்த
நல்ல அதான்
ஜஸ்ட் அந்த லிங்க் எங்க இருந்ததுன்னு எனக்கு சட்டு
கரெக்ட் தான். நீ கேட்டாதான் எனக்கே தோன்றது.
அக்கா இல்ல இல்ல எனக்கு புரியல அவ்வளவுதான். What is that link, Akka? I missed that point. What is
the relentless attitude that a Kami has to placate or to you know, comfort his beloved. This Sharagni also has that relentless attitude in just continuously attacking the people in that Tripuram.
Okay.
And it is also capable of removing our papam because it is very strong. It has such an extraordinary power. That's what trying to ask. Just slipped. Okay. So, yatra hi rasasya vakyarthi bhavaha tatra katham alankaratvam. So, where, now he says, where rasa is pradhanam, vakyarthi bhavaha pradhani bhutaha. So, yatra rasaha pradhani bhutaha tatra katham alankaratvam rasasya katham alankaratvam syat. So that is the difference between rasavad alankara and rasa. If the main purpose of a verse is to highlight the rasam and give us that rasa enjoyment. In all of this shlokam, in the two shlokas that we saw, we only think of the king's greatness or Shiva's greatness here. So it is a namaskaratmakam or ashirvadatmakam, maha duritam dahatu. But that rasa helps us to enjoy only as an alankara. It is only an alankara. The alankarya vastu is not the rasam here. So tatra yatra rasaha alankarya vastu bhavati, tatra rasasya alankaratvam na bhavati, sayeva atma bhavati. So alankaraha hi charutvahetuhu prasiddha. It is known as a charutvahetu. It is something only that which decorates something else. So natu asau atma eva atma atmanaha charutva hetuhu. Atma cannot be the soul, or the self cannot be the decorative factor for us, for the self itself. So it has to have something external to decorate the soul. So this atma is the alankarya vastu. The alankarya vastu cannot become the alankaraha. Tathacha ayamatra sankshepaha. रसभावादितात्पर्यम् आश्रित्य विनिवेशनम् अलङ्कृतीनां सर्वासाम् अलङ्कारत्व साधनम् द अलङ्कृति गेट्स् द स्टेटस् आफ् एन् अलङ्कार अलङ्कृति और् अलङ्कार इस् द सेम् सो अलङ्कृतीनाम् अलङ्कारत्व अलङ्कारभाव साधनम् it can only get the status of an alankara if it is employed or if it is used vinivesanam katham rasabhavadi tatparyam ashritya. If it is used in such a manner that it depends on rasa bhava, rasabhasa, bhavabhasa, etc., etc., then it gains the status of an alankara. Then it can be called as an alankara. Otherwise, it is the so tasmat, you understand the karika, right? So rasa bhavadi tatparyam ashritya yatra alankara alankritinam vinivesanam bhavati तत्रैव सर्वासाम् अलङ्कृतीनाम् अलङ्कारत्वसाधनम् अलङ्कारः इति नाम कर्तुं शक्यते. तस्मात् यत्र रसादयः वाक्यार्थीभूताः, वेर् एवर् द रस इस् प्रधानम्, प्रधानतया यत्र रसाः भासन्ते, स सर्वः अपि न रसादेः अलङ्कार न रसादेः अलङ्कारस्य विषयः, सः ध्वनेः प्रभेदः. If the rasa is a vakyarthi bhuta, that is, if it is the pradhanam, then it is dhvanif prabheda, asamlakshikramadhvani, and not rasadi alankara. Tasya upamadayaha alankaraha, tasya rasadhvanehe cha upamadayaha alankaraha bhavanti. Artha alankaraha, shabda alankaraha api, tasya rasadhvanehe eva alankaraha bhavanti. यत्र तु प्राधान्येन अर्थान्तरस्य वाक्यार्थी भावे, जस्ट् लैक् हौ वि सो नौ शिवस्य प्रभावः अथवा नृपतिप्रभावः, यत्र अर्थान्तरस्य रसात् अन्यस्य अर्थस्य वाक्यार्थी भावे सति, प्रधाने सति. वेन् एनदर् वस्तु और् अन् अलङ्कारं बिकम्स् वाक्यार्थ और् प्रधानम्, रसादिभिः चारुत्वनिष्पत्तिः क्रियते, सः रसादेः अलङ्कारतायाः विषयः. वेन् वि वाण्ट् टु हैलैट् सम् अदर् आस्पेक्ट् यूसिङ्ग् अ रस, वि यूस् रसादिभिः चारुत्वनिष्पत्तिः. सो वि यूस् द रस एण्ड् ब्रिङ्ग् अबौट् अ चमत्कारं टु दट् वाक्यार्थ, दट् प्रधानभूत अर्थः. वि यूस् द रसम्. See, rasa, just because rasa has become an alankara, has taken an alankara status, it doesn't mean that it has to be removed from the picture at all. It is not bad. It is a good one. But the way he says it is pradhanyena arthantarasya vakyarthi bhave sati. Anyaha arthaha yatra pradhanataya bhasate tatra rasadibihi charutva nishpattihi rasadine upayujya चारुत्वम् आददते. सो वि ब्रिङ्ग् अबौट् अ ब्यूटि फार् दट् प्रधान विषयं यूसिङ्ग् दि रस एक्सेट्रा, रस भाव तदाभास एक्सेट्रा. देर् ओन्लि रसादेः अलङ्कारतायाः विषयः, दट् बिकम्स् द विषयं फार् द सब्जेक्ट् म्याटर् फार् रसवदलङ्कार. एवं ध्वनेः उपमादीनां विभक्तविषयता, ध्वनेः रसवदलङ्कारस्य च विभक्तविषयता. दि स्माल् पेसेज् गिव्स् यू द डिफरेन्स् बिट्वीन् ध्वनि एण्ड् उपमा एण्ड् ध्वनि एण्ड् रसवदलङ्कार. ध्वनि रसध्वनि इस् दट् विच् वेर् रसम् इस् गेट्स् द प्रामिनेन्स् इन् द श्लोकम् एण्ड् रसवदलङ्कार उपमा एक्सेट्रा बिकम् दि अलङ्कारः एण्ड् द रस इस् दि अलङ्कार्य वस्तु दट् इस् युवर् ध्वनि. सो ध्वनिः उपमादिभ्यः भिद्यते. नेक्स्ट् ध्वनेः रसवदलङ्कारस्य च विभक्तविषयता कथम्? सो ध्वनि वेन् रस इस् युर् प्रधानता देन् दट् इस् दि अलङ्कार्य वस्तु देन् इट् इस् रसध्वनि. इफ् दट् प्रधान इफ् दट् रसं बिकम्स् अ सबोर्डिनेट् टु सम् अदर् अर्थं like the prabhavaha or rati deva vishayakam anything else then that is a rasavadalankara place sthala. Okay, evam dvanehe upamadinam rasavadalankarasya cha vibhakta vishayata. Now he starts a small discussion chetana chetana vishaye. So yaditu चेतनाचेतनानां वाक्यार्थीभावः रसाद्यलङ्कारस्य विषयः इत्युच्यते, तर्हि उपमादीनां प्रविरलविषयता निर्विषयता वा अभिहिता स्यात्. दिस् इस् इन् कीपिङ्ग् वित् एन् ओल्डर् ट्रेडिशन् आफ् आलङ्कारिका वेर् ए सेट् आफ् आलङ्कारिकास् फील् दट् ओन्लि दोस् श्लोकास् विच् हेव् चेतनवस्तु डिस्क्रिप्शन् ओन्लि दोस् केन् बि rasavadalankara. Those are all okay. That is also the standpoint of people who have not accepted rasadhvani. Okay, is because dhvani is the concept that Anandavardhana has put forth. So this particular concept is something which people who do not accept rasadhvani, but they know that rasam exists, they only think of rasa as another alankara vastu. They don't talk of it as the soul of a poetry. So rasadi alankarasya vishayah yatra chetananam vakyarthi bhavah vidyate tatraiva rasadi alankarasya vishayah ityuchyate. Tarhi, then what happens is there are so many shlokas where there is an achetana vastu vishayah. That achetana vastu vishayah, those are all of those will become, then we won't even have a place for upama etc. Apannuti, when we are talking about Apannuti, when you are reading the shlokam Ankanke Pishashankire Jalanidhe Pankam Paremenire, you are talking about Chandra, which is an Achetana Vastu. So many people are thinking of different things for that Chandra, right? The moon. How can you say it is without Rasam? So Rasavatta Nasti Iti Tesham Matihi. Tan nirasaya atra arabhyate. So he gives three examples to substantiate that even though there is a chetana vastu vishayam, there is a chetana vastu aropaha and it becomes rasavatta. If you look at just if in Kumarasambhava third sarga, there is a description of achetana vastu vishayam, a lot of spring description is there. In other words, it just ends up being vibhava. It ends up being an uddipana vibhavam for the main context. Okay, so it's not just, even in Megha Sandesham, the entire this description of a megham, which is an achetana vastu, it is not a chetana vastu. The entire thing is depends on the chetanatva aropaha. Adina chetana chetananam dhumajyotis sarira marutam sannivatah kvamegaha sandeshartah kava padukulanehi pranibhi prapaniyaha ityotsukya lala anna chetana chetananam அதென்னமா மறந்து விடுதே. ஓகே சரி, ஞாபகம் வந்தா ஜஸ்ட் டெல் மீ. தட்ஸ் அ வெரி நைஸ் யூ வில் சே வேர் பீப்புள் ஹூ ஆர் இன் ஸ்ருங்கார ரசம் தே டோன்ட் ஹாவ் எனி தே கெனாட் டிஃபரன்ஷியேட் பிட்வீன் சேத்தனா அண்ட் அச்சேதன வஸ்து. ஸோ எவ்ரி திங் என்ஸ் அப் பீங் அ விபாவ வென் தெர் இஸ் அன் அச்சேதன வஸ்து விற்பாந்தம். ஸோ எதி தூ சேத்தனா, தட் இஸ் த கன்க்ளூஷன் ஆஃப் திஸ் ஆர்குமெண்ட். ஸோ வி வில் கோ வித் த text now. Yadi tu chetananam vakyarthi bhavah eva rasadhyalankarasya vishayah ityuchyate. This is purupaksha stance. So if you say that only those places where a Chetana Vastu is employed, only if a Chetana Vastu Vishaya is there, only that is Rasavattvam, then what happens is Tarhi Upamadinam Pravirala Vishayata. The Upama etc. Alankaras, the Upama etc. would find very less stance in the Alankara Shastra. Right? Nirvishayata or Praviralam means very less places of Upama Alankaram. When you say there is an Achetana Vastu here, I cannot say that there is Upama Alankaram here. Because every Upama Alankara has an Achetana Vastu there. There is a non-living thing which is being described there. Right? So Nirvishayata or wherever you want to describe the Naika's face, you are saying Chandraha. So Chandra Iva Mukham. That will also be you cannot consider it as an upamasthalam, correct? So va abhihitasyat yasmad achetana vastu vritte vakyarthi bhute punaha chetana vastu vrittanta yojanaya yatha kathanchit bhavitavyam. In some way or the other, wherever when an achetana vastu is the purport of the shloka, yatra yasmad achetana vastu vritte vakyarthi bhute Sandeshartha, Kamartha hi Prakriti Kripana, Chetana, Chetaneshu. Kamartha hi, those who are suffering from Kama, the Manmatha effect. Prakriti Kripana, they are extremely, Dainyasthala. They don't understand the difference between Chetana and Achetana Vastu. His whole lyric, Kandakavyam, is based on that assumption, right? He starts off with that hypothesis. Then the entire Megha Sandesham, you should say that it is Nirasattva. So, yasmat, Achetana Vastu Vritte, when there is a description of an Achetana Vastu, Vakyarthi Bhute Sati, when that gains a prominence in a verse, Punaha Chetana Vastu Vrittanta Yojanaya, you add a Chetana Vastu there, or there is a Chetana Vastu Aropaha Kriyate, superimposition of a Chetana Vastu, and Bhavitavyam, that should be there. Atha satyam api tasyam. Yatra achetananam vakyarthi bhavaha nasau rasavadalankarasya vishayaha ityuchyate tat mahataha kavyaprabandasya rasanidanabhutasya nirasattvam abhitam syat. If atha tasyam satyam api yatra achetananam vakyarthi bhavaha tasyam satyam api abdina, where there is a chetana vrittanta yojana. Tasyam satyamapi, chetana vrittanta yojanayamapi, achetananam vakyarthi bhavaha yatra na yatra achetananam vakyarthi bhavaha tatra rasavadalankarasya vishayaha na saha rasavadalankara vishayaha na iti yat uchyate tarhi. That is also another purvapaksham. Even if there is a vakya, the Chetana Vastu Aropaha, even then, if the Achetana Vastu is the Vakyarthi Bhavaha, that is, if the Achetana Vastu is the Pradhanam, Tarhi Tatrapi Rasavadalankarasya Vishayaha Na Bhavati Iti Purvakshanam Matam. Tarhi Tasma Tat, then, Mahataha Kavya Prabandhasya Rasa Nidana Bhutasya. The most famous example is Megasandesham. Kavya Prabandhasya, Mahan Kavya Prabandhaha, rasa nidana bhutaha asti tasya nirasatvam syat. You have to accept that it has no essence at all. You cannot enjoy the rasam from it. But pratyakshama, we have seen even in Champu Ramayanam, where when Hanuman stands on the Mahindra mountain and he just jumps. You don't need only Shringara rasam here. Any rasam can be employed. Not only Shringara or Vipralambha. When Hanuman stands on that Mahendra mountain and then jumps off to cross the ocean, there is one huge Gadya description. He says, he describes the Kashtam Daustyam. He says, Dustha, Duravastha, Mahendra Girehe, Duravastha Varnayati. How if you crush a person, or you just stand on a person and, crush him, what are all the things that man will experience? He describes everything in that mountain, like nerves will just show out and then your hair will just be disheveled. He will describe it in such a manner. That is that Adbhuta Rasam. the way it contributes to Hanumat Prabhavam there. Hanumat Prabhavaha is there. And in that Gadhyam especially, it is the Vakyarthi Bhava is the description of the Mahendra mountain is the Vakyarthi Bhava. That is the Pradhana Bhutam there. The Chetana Vastu Aropaha is how a man experiences kashtam, physical pain, in the same way, you know, it resembles a man experiencing a physical pain. You can't say it is a nirasattva. Beautiful passage that is. So tat mahataha kavya prabandasya rasanidana bhutasya, for a kavyam which has so much of rasam and essence in it, it will become nirasam. Nirasattvam abhitam syat yatha. He gives quotes examples, three examples, where if we say there is no, because it is an achetana vastu vrittantam, if we say there is no rasam, then there is no prayojanam at all, right? So taranga bhubhangaha, we'll take up these three shlokas next class. Okay. Thought we could finish this today. There's no time. We'll take another half an hour. Okay. என்ன புரியல
எனக்கு அச்சேதன வஸ்துவ டிஸ்கிரைப் பண்ணா அது வந்து ரசம் இல்லன்னு சொல்றா.
எஸ் இட் இஸ் நாட் ரசவத் அலங்கார.
ஓகே, அப்ப சமாசோக்தி எல்லாம் என்ன சொல்றா இவா? அந்த மாதிரி அலங்காரம் தான்
இட் இஸ் அலங்காரம். ரசவத் அலங்காரம்னு சொல்றோங்கிற அவசியம் இல்ல. இட் இஸ் ஒன்லி சமாசோக்தி.
ஓகே,
சோ யூ கேன் கால் இட் அ சமாசோக்தி. இல்ல, wherever there is, see, this is just one small group of alankarika who believe that only if there is a conscious being, sentient being which is being described, only then there is rasatvam. If there is an insentient being that is being described, it is not rasatvam.
So and rasama angama kuda iva ottukaradilla appo. Okay sari
rasatvam angaradu eppo varum? When can you experience emotions? Only when there is a sentience. If you are talking about an insentient being experiencing rasam, there is no rasatvam there.
Rasa basama kuda va ottukalaya idha? Oh, adu kuda okay.
Illa, andha madri concept illa anga. So it is just a very small section of people. So we don't even know who that Purupakshi is.
Oh, sorry.
எங்கயாவது ஒரு ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட் இருக்கும், தெரியாது. தேர் ஆர் சி ஐ டோல்ட் யூ ரைட், தேர் இஸ் ஆல்வேஸ் த டார்க் பீரியட் இன் ஹிஸ்டரி. தேர் ஆர் லாட் ஆஃப் லிட்ரேச்சர் தட் இஸ் லாஸ்ட் இந்த பிஃபோர் த குப்தா பீரியட். மெனி தேர் வேர் மெனி வியாக்கியானம் ஃபார் நாட்டியசாஸ்திரம் விச் ஆர் லாஸ்ட் ஓவர் த பீரியட் ஆஃப் டைம். ஸோ யூ டோன்ட் நோ விச் ஸ்மால் செக்ஷன் தட் ஹி சேஸ், ஆர் இட் குட் ஜஸ்ட் பி அ ஸ்மால் வாக்கியார்த்த சதஸ் தட் மைட் ஹவ் ஹேப்பன்ட் இன் அ சபா, இன் அ ராஜ்யசபா. சம்வன் மைட் ஹவ் ஜஸ்ட் செட், ஹவு கேன் தேர் பி இமோஷன் வென் யூ ஆர் ட்ரைங் டு டிஸ்கிரைப் அ கிரீப்பர்? ஸோ ஹி மைட் ஹவ் ஜஸ்ட் டேக்கன் தட் ஆஸ் அ லைன் அண்ட் செட் இட் ஹியர். இட் மே நாட் பி அ டெக்ஸ்ட் இன் விச் திஸ் லைன் அப்பியர்ஸ் ஆஸ் அ பூர்வபக்ஷ, இல்லையா? எது வேணாலும் இருக்கலாம். சம்வன் ஹூ வாண்ட்ஸ் டு யூ நோ டிஸ்பியூட் ஹிஸ் வியூ, it may be just a living room discussion which could have come up with such ideas.
Okay,
sorry. Appadi paaru ellathukku vandu namba source text thedanonna it will be difficult. We are already dealing with something which happened in the 19th century. Yeah,
sorry. Puriyadhu.
Yeah, namaste.